there is a barcode here, so you drop it in like that, okay? And then make sure that only this one goes in, right? And then facing out, and then you spike your heparin saline. So put in, if you have a 500 ml of saline, put in 2,005 units of heparin. If you have a bigger, like 1 liter saline, you put in 5,000 units of heparin. So you just half it, okay? Then once you spike it, all right, you can close.
So it will automatically
yes.
remove everything?
Yes, because there's a bubble detector and also a pressure detector inside. So not to worry if you see any bubbles here. As
so you don't have to put in syringe or everything?
No need. You need to prime it now. So now once your... Your doctor has actually holding on to your catheter and your pump is being dropped inside close. You see that there is a negative seconds here. So this will tell you you have to flush it for 15 seconds. It will count down for you. To start off your first catheter, it will count down for you. And here it will tell you what to do in case you forget. Okay? And these, there are also visuals to sort of like tell you what you should do. Okay? So now you need to prime. So immerse fully the two markers so that you make sure that all the holes are inside submerged into your saline, okay? And Dr. Sabari, can you help step? Yeah. So once you continue with this, alright, and you see that it will calm down for you. So once it reaches zero, you can stop. And you're ready to go into your patient. That's all. Okay? So once you let's say you activate, like let's say let's say you start sucking, you wanna use it to suck? Okay. Bear in mind I don't have a guide wire right now. Okay. So this is just to teach you how to run
Advance.
Yeah, advance saja. Okay, then you are done. Yeah, that fast. Okay. So you see there's a replacement of water your saline into your patient. This is you will also see about the same amount being sucked out. It's isovolumetric.
So the blood
inside. So what you see inside the bag, you will be actually half. Saline and half
blood. Blood also be sucked
yes,
in, isn't
correct.
It? So if you suck too long, then patient will be anemic.
That's why we have your run time to check. Okay? And then maximum you can only remove 1 liter of blood, which is actually half is blood sahaja. And also it depends whether your vessel is completely occluded. So probably you won't suck out so much of blood after all. Okay. Next thing you will see that there's also your volume being sucked up. So it will tell you your volume. Okay. So continuously, if let's say okay, now you want to do stenting ballooning, then you take out your catheter, you need to flush this. Okay? So then you just make use of your priming time to determine how long to flush off this so that you can keep your catheter aside. Okay. So maybe you do a 15.
So after each suction, yeah. Then you can flush.
Yeah, you can flush it. Yeah. So you just flush.
15 seconds.
Yeah. Okay. Just now was you activated 8 minutes to clear the clots, right? So you just add another. If you do not want to add it like that, okay, you can. Okay, you can just reset, and you can start on with that. So you can play with it on how you want to do it. Okay. This is a peripheral catheter where you have over the wire system. Okay. There is the rapid exchange system where I don't have my demo set here. But it works the same. Okay. So what you need to know is for the spiral flex catheter that you have requested, there's a stylet. So what you do is remove the stylet and then you can do your flushing. Okay. Okay. So if you see this hub, this is the hemostasis hub. Okay. And when you thread through your guide wire from the tip, okay, make sure that you open it. To open it like that. Okay. You can try this here. Okay. You can just pass this around to show how it is. Okay. Because if it's not locked, all your blood will puncture keluar when you activate your system. So to lock it, once you get your guide wire out, you just lock it. You will hear a click sound. So you just remember this. So maybe your nurses can just remind you whether it's locked.
When you lock, can you still advance?
Yeah. This is just to, you know, help you close off your blood by not flowing out. Okay. You will see, can you see like this lumen here? If let's say, if you suck out traumas and everything, you see all this is full with blood as well. Because whenever your jet is pushing out your saline, and then this bigger lumen is the lumen when it comes out to actually goes into your back. Okay? So if let's say when you start activating your catheter, alright, you see that there's no flow, if there's no blood, you know that it's a complete occlusion of your vessel already. So all these small little thing will help you to determine how long you can run. So if let's say you want to run a little bit, you know, additional, you may still do so, but you just have to take care of hemolysis and.
So if you use the wire can connect then the provided easier, isn't it? Rather than the twist one.
No, because this one is over the wire, your normal rapid exchange will not have this.
Okay.
Yeah. Your rapid exchange will not have this. I'm showing this to you because you can make use of this to do what's that? Power pulse. Okay, power pulse only the purple color catheter can do it. So how you do your power pulse is, you see, like first, okay, and then you just press the catheter button because it tells you power pulse, spray optional. You press the catheter button, and this is press catheter button for power pulse. So you press it again and it tell you, do you want to enable your power pulse? So if yes, you just press this button, the star here, okay, and you press okay. And it tells you PP means you're in power pulse mode now. So now you cannot suck out, but you can only infuse lytics. So this screen will tell you how much of lytic you will infuse as well. Okay, CC here means every pulse, it gives you 0.6 CC. 0.6 ml. So you just see this here. So you just do your pulse like that. So it gives you this.
So the lytic you have to put in. Yeah.
Yes, okay. How you do your lytics? Okay, I'm going to show you. How you do your lytics is, let's say you have another 50 ml saline of, your saline 50 ml, okay? So you inject in your lytics inside, alright? So you hang it on this side, you can leave your normal saline there. Unspike this, alright? Spike it into this because now you want to deliver lytics, okay? And then you flush. Like how your catheter first gives you the flushing is minus 15, right? So you do the same thing so that when you start to go into your patient, your catheter tip, okay, you would have your lytics already. Alright, so you do the same, you unspike, spike into your lytics bag, okay, and then you run for 15 seconds.
Flush, you use the sorry, flush.
It's the same. So because this one is pulsing in, so by the time you pulse, let's say you pulse 15 seconds, right, you would have all push out all your lytics into the end here and out. Yeah. So same thing, after you have finished delivering your lytics, you unspike it, spike it back to your normal saline bag, and then do your flush again, because then you do not want to infuse any more lytics. So this is how you work.
So this is a sterile part,
yeah, the whole fact is, you know, it comes in the sterile part, and this is the sterile part where you will be working, and the rest you can use your.
This one also should be sterile, isn't it?
Yeah, because the whole pack.
This one, it comes together.
You don't have to connect. Yeah. Why we do this? Because the old system, you see, it looks like a fridge, right? That old system has a pump, you connect, catheter, you connect. And once you have more connections, you will introduce air. So that's why we come up with an integrated pump set together with the catheter. Makes life easier for anyone to set up as well, and it's faster. That's the...
Everything connected lah. So bila buka tu, this one ada non-sterile resistant, just ambil yang then the sleeve is probably this part ni, sterile.
Yes, correct. So I will also teach you how to dismantle very easy your eject button.
Just easy.
Just take out the whole set and buang lah. That's all.
RM6,000.
Yeah, it makes life easier for you. Okay. So Dr. Sapawi, what I'll do is maybe you want all your nurses to be trained, right? Everyone will run through.